Hello students, I hope you are doing great. I am Vijita Bichar from Saraswati Group of Education. In the previous session, we completed poem 1 and its exercise, notes and all the worksheets. Now, it's time to start with the new chapter, that is chapter number 2, the two sculptors. What is the name of the chapter? The two sculptors. But before we start any of the chapter or poem explanation, we understand the meanings of new words related to the chapter. So, let us understand all the new words related to the chapter, that is the two sculptors.
Okay kids, now let us understand the meanings of vocabulary words of chapter 2, the two sculptors. But before we understand the meanings of all these words, let us go through all the words once. Statue, S-T-A-T-U-E, statue. S-C-U-L-P-T-U-R-E, sculpture. S-U-B-J-E-C-T-S, subjects. K-I-N-G-D-O-M, kingdom. S-C-U-L-P-T-O-R, sculptor. D-E-F-E-A-T, defeat. L-E-N-D, land. G-L-A-D-L-Y, gladly. B-L-U-N-T, blunt. B-U-S-T, burst. H-E-R-A-L-D, herald. C-A-R-V-E-D, card. M-E-A-N, mean. R-E-W-A-R-D-E-D, rewarded. And the last, F-O-L-L-Y, folly. So, these are the words totally new for you. So, listen carefully and understand the meanings of all the words properly. First word is statue. Statue is an image or a figure of a person or animal that is made up of stone or wood or bronze, copper, brass. It can be made up of clay, stones, right? The statue is a character of ambitious person. Right? Why do we create statue? We create statue in the memory of somebody, in respect of somebody. Right? Here you can see the image, that is statue of unity of our Indian leader Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Right? He spent a lot of struggle in his life for freedom. Yes, so in respect of them, we create a statue of unity. Right? One more example, the statue we cast in bronze. The statue was cast in bronze. Right? The statue can be made up of different materials like bronze, copper, brass, clay, maybe made up of stones, right? So, this statue of unity was created in bronze. Next is sculpture. Sculpture, which means art. In simple word, we say sculpture is an art of making figures or model, right? Sculpture means the figures or object made from clay, stones or wood or metal, right? For example, the children made sculpture out of clay. Yes, children made sculpture or art out of clay. So, in simple word, sculpture, which means an art of making figures or model. Next word is sculptors. As we have learned about statue, by whom the statue was created, that person is called sculptors. Sculptors is an artist who make a sculptures, who make a statue, right? For example, the sculptor carved the girl out of clay. Means the sculptor, the artist, create the statue of girl out of clay. Okay, they represents the statue of a person or animals. Sculptor is an artist who take materials and use different tools. With the help of that, they mold the material and they create a statue. Next word is subject. Here, the subject, which means not the subjects that we are studying like English, essays, Hindi, right? These are not the subject in this chapter. In accordance or relevant to the chapter, here the subject means people living in that particular country. Yes, the public or citizen of a country, that is called subjects. Okay, for example, king's subjects loved him very much. Listen carefully. King's subjects, which means people. King's people loved him very much. One more example. Have you seen the movie The Lion King? Yes, in this there was a king called Simba. Yes, and all the animals loved him very much. All the subjects loved Simba very much. Next is kingdom. Kingdom, which means the country, the state or territory ruled by king or queen. Kingdom is the country, right? The place which is ruled by king or queen. Or we can say a kingdom is a place or area which is run by a specific head person. That is called kingdom. For example, the kingdom appears peaceful from distance. Here you can see the kingdom means the place. That Raj Mahal is called kingdom. Yes, and it looks very peaceful. Right? Kingdom is very beautiful. Let me give you one more example. In the movie Lion King, the Simba ruled over the jungle, right? After his father died. So, the Simba is ruled over the place. That place, that jungle is called kingdom. Okay? Next is defeat. Defeat, which means to win over someone in a contest. In simple words, defeat means to win a game against somebody. For example, the king defeated in the war. The king won in the war. Next example, the Simba defeat to the Scar and Hyena. In the Lion King movie, the Scar and Hyena are the villain in the movie. And at the end, at last, in the movie, Simba overcome against Scar and Hyena. Okay? Let me give you one more example, that is Jenny defeat the Harry in a quiz competition. Means Jenny overcome in a contest, or we can say Jenny win the contest. Next is lend. L-E-N-D, lend. Lend, which means to give something. Yes? This is not L-E-N-D, lend. L-E-N-D, lend. Lend, which means to give something, to allow somebody to use your thing for a short period of time. Yes? If you give your pencil to your friend to use for a short period of time, then it means you lend pencil to your friend. Okay? For example, will you lend me your bicycle? If you will lend your bicycle to your friend for one day, yes? So, it means you lend your bicycle to your friend for a day. One more example that is related to the picture that you see. Please lend me your tools. Here you can see in the picture. Yes, there are two persons. One person is asking that, please lend me your tools. And the another person is giving his tools to the person for a use to short period of time. Okay, so the person is lend his tools to use. Next word is gladly. Gladly, which means willingly or happily, or we can say with pleasure. To accept something with pleasure. Okay? For example, I accept your friendship gladly. Or I can give you the example, Tom has accepted Harry's friendship gladly. Yes, the Tom accepted the friendship with pleasure, with happily. Okay? One more example, the king gladly accepted the invitation. The king accepted the invitation with pleasure, with happiness. So, in simple word, gladly means to accept something with pleasure or with happiness. Next word is blunt. Blunt, which means not sharp. Very flat and rough. You can see the picture. There are two pencils. The first pencil that is held by a girl is blunt, right? The pencil is blunt. Its point is not sharp. And one more picture of a pencil that is held by a boy, and the point of the pencil is sharp, right? So blunt means not sharp. Yes, if a scissor is not sharp, then it will useless. If the knife is blunt, then it's useless. For example, he was sawing or cutting the bread with a blunt knife. The boy was cutting the bread with a blunt knife. not use the sharp knife. One more example, all the tools of the sculptor become blunt. Yes, the sculptor, the artist who made statue. Yes, with the help of tools. But the tools are blunt. Then it is useless, right? So blunt, which means not sharp. Next is bust. Bust means a specific part of a statue that includes the head or face of a sculpture. Yes, a model of a person's head or shoulders and chest. Yes, the model which includes person's head, shoulders and chest, that specific part, that is called bust. For example, it is a bust cut from stone. Yes, you can see the picture. In the picture, we can see the specific part of the statue, that is head, shoulder, face and chest. Yes, though, that is called bust. For example, Lakshman made bust of a king. Lakshman made bust of a king means Lakshman made a model of king up to his head, shoulders and chest. Next word is herald. Herald is an official in a court who announces the things. Okay? Herald means a person who brings a news or announces an official message. Yes? Herald is the name of a specific person who announces specific news or specific message. That person is called herald. Okay? For example, the king heralded to begin the war. The king announced. Finally, the king made an official announcement to begin the war. Okay? So, the person who makes announcement is called herald. Next word is carved. Carved, which means to shape up something or to create something. Yes, with the help of material, with the help of big stone, with the help of big wood, a specific shape is created. That is called carve. To cut wood or stone in order to make a particular object. Yes, that is called carve. For example, the statue was carved out of marble. Yes, the statue was created. The statue was shaped out of marble. In simple word, we can say something that cut in a pattern to create a statue. Mean, which means unkind or unfair. People who is unkind or unfriendly, behavior of a people, right? Or we can say a person who is rude is called mean. For example, Tom is very mean as he broken others' things. Right? So here the Tom is very rude because he did not value others' things. Yes, he is very unkind. Yes, because he broken others' thing. So the Tom is very mean. Next word is rewarded. Rewarded, which means something that is given in return for a good. Yes, to give something to somebody because he or she had done something good or worked hard. Yes, in simple words, we can say to achieve something through hard work and effort. If we are doing hard work and effort, and in return we get some prize, that is called reward. Okay? For example, finally Tina's efforts were rewarded and she got first rank. Yes, the Tina's hard work and efforts were rewarded as she got first rank. Last word is folly. Folly, which means the foolish act of idea. We can say foolishness or stupidity. For example, someone intentionally teases others. Yes, if someone is intentionally teasing others, then that person is folly. Or one more example is, here you can see in the picture, a person is cutting the branch on which he is sitting. So it shows the foolishness of that person, right? So folly, which means stupidity or foolishness. Thank you. I hope you all have understand the meanings of all the words.
At the end of this video lecture, you are going to get worksheet. In this worksheet, I have mentioned two questions. In question A, write the followings are given.